Hello and welcome to the Diplomat Couch. My name is Osley Matsikenyeri. Today we are at the annual Diplomat Awards, which seek to honor and award ambassadors and organizations that are making a significant contribution to the country of Zimbabwe and its people. This year, the annual Diplomat Awards are celebrating 10 years of existence, and their theme is a decade of service. Shall you join me inside as we follow the proceedings?
Of the day, neighbors will greet each other, sisters and brothers, even enemies will come to be friends. I can't wait to be there in line. No. I can't wait to be there in line. No.
Really nice to have you all around, Your Excellencies, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Love Moore, and the surname is Changira. I'm your Director of Ceremonies today. Thank you so much for coming. Now, I had already given introductory remarks. I would like to obviously welcome the guest of honor, famous man, Dr. Solomon Gramatino. Welcome, sir. Thank you. Moving on with the program, I'd like to invite the chairperson of the awards committee, Mr. Avind Neya, to come through and give us his opening remarks.
I'm delighted to welcome you to the 10th edition of the annual Diplomat of the Year Awards. Following a COVID-19 induced break, the award ceremony is taking place a morning event instead of the evening event you have all become accustomed to. I would like to express my gratitude to Stanbic Bank and Optineva for their unwavering support and in partnership in delivering these awards. I would also like to thank the embassies, non-government organizations, business and other high-level representatives for joining us from different walks of life. A special welcome also goes to the institutions that are receiving accolades today. Congratulations, Makorokoto, well done. You are being recognized for the exemplary efforts in implementing innovative solutions in the area of, number one, poverty alleviation, peace building, economic inclusion, gender equality, health, environment, and climate action. Running under the theme, A Decade of Service, this year's edition is a celebration of 10 years since the establishment of the awards and an amplified call for the attainment of the substantial development goals. Instead of focusing on the diplomats only as usual, the awards are honoring seven organizations that have impacted positively on the lives of Zimbabweans, especially the poor and the marginalized groups. Can we give a round of applause to that, please? This year's awards are also appreciate the embassies and ambassadors who have supported these organizations in implementing their programs and those who have actively supported other substantial development initiatives. Can we also give them a round of applause, please? Initiatives by the winning institutions have improved the quality of life for citizens through improved healthcare, gender equality, youth engagement and civic education, community based on renewable power solutions and substantial waste management, among other initiatives. The Diplomats Business Network stands ready to facilitate a continued exchange of ideas and innovations for improved community and leadership development across Zimbabwe. Thank you very much, Your Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, Tatenda.
It gives me great pleasure this morning to stand in front of you at the 10th edition of the annual Diplomat of the Year Awards, running under the theme, A Decade of Service. These awards are presented to outstanding diplomats and organizations who have shown a passion to make a positive impact on the lives of the ordinary Zimbabwean, as well as relating well with other ambassadors. As the Director of Ceremonies has already mentioned, Stanbic Bank Zimbabwe has supported these awards from their inception 10 years ago, is they are in sync with what we believe in. As such, we are here to celebrate outstanding service from various organizations, most of whom are our partners. And again, we are very proud to be partnered with the Diplomatic Awards, which are 10 years old.
Our wonderful sponsors, thank you so much. And we look forward to continuing this partnership for many more years to come. Is she hearing me? All right, wonderful. Thank you so much for making this event happen. I would like now to invite a special man, our guest of honor, Dr. Solomon Gramatuno. He is a philanthropist of note. He is a man who is concerned about the upliftment of the poor. He is a man who would like to see the best in our communities. I don't want to steal the thunder from him because there is something that he's going to do after his speech. So he is a man of excellence. And ladies and gentlemen, let's give him a round of applause as he comes to the podium to deliver his address.
Well, thank you, Lovemo. The chairman of the Diplomats Business Network, Zibeya, Reginald. I have to thank you, Reginald, because I remember when you started. And obviously, you've been very consistent. And it's nice to see all these excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, here. For me, this is quite an honor to come and address you. But in short, I'll say this to you. Those of us who are Zimbabwean, when we travel and we go, say, to Mumbai, we go to Shanghai or Beijing, and you see these cities, the population is more than a million, more than 20 million people. And then we look at Zimbabwe, we are only about 15 million people. And then we say, well, we have diamonds, we have gold, platinum, we have chrome, we have lithium, we have all these minerals, and we have fantastic soil. But we have this poverty among us. So we ask ourselves, how do we change our situation? And I must thank you all here because I know you've been doing a lot to change or to alleviate poverty among our people. I won't say much because a young lady came to see me 2 days ago and I said, wow. She told me what she was doing. We believe now the development has from bottom up rather than from top bottom. This is the only way we think we can make a real change. Therefore, I thank you all for doing this. I'm going to ask this young lady, Blessing Nyamparaza, to come and make this presentation. Thank you very much.
A good day to you all, ladies and gentlemen, your excellencies. First and foremost, I would like to acknowledge the presence of all the excellencies here. And also, I would like to thank you, Doc Gramatun, for giving me such an opportunity. In 2014, I was in grade 2 at Nyachuru Primary School in Howard Chiweshe Mashonaland Central. Seeing other children coming to school in torn uniforms, insufficient school fees, and unpacked lunch boxes left a question mark in me. When I discovered that they were coming from disadvantaged learners, I knew I had to take action. This is when it created a passion in me of helping other disadvantaged learners in the society. Chipo Chikwaza is a very good example. Her mother was forced into marrying a foreman. You can imagine how it would be to her. So when the father died, it was hell on earth for her. She had insufficient school fees, stationery, and even books so that she could go on with schoolwork. So I paid fees, bought stationery, and bought uniforms for her so that she could attend school. With this, she gained confidence in herself. So I discovered that not only Chipo had the same situation, but many other students, but due to insufficient funds, I could not take all the demands. When we moved to Centenary, which is in Mzarabani district, and Mzarabani district is a district which has high rates of early child marriages, school dropouts, and it is even poverty stricken. So I also had to transfer the project to the same district. For instance, there's a boy called Laikam Dar. Her parents were not employed, so they could not even pay for a fee so that he could go to school. So I paid the fees and bought all that was necessary so that he could go to school. With this, he even gained focus in school, and he was enrolled in the school's special class. He no longer felt out of place among others because he had all the basic commodities. The projects were passed on to Centenary High School, which has got the same projects but also extended to gardening and running a school tuck shop. My vision is to create a nation which has got lesser and, if possible, not at all, learners who are not going to school because of insufficient funds. I also want a nation that has got youth that are empowered so that they can earn a living in the society. By so doing, it will be creating a better Zimbabwe and as well as creating a better Africa at large. That is why I established the Stable Children's Foundation Trust so that I could establish solid basis, firmly established for children with disadvantages. As a matter of fact, early January next year, you are all invited to Nyarushishi High School, where the Stable Children's Foundation Club will be launched officially. They will be handed over goat and fowl project so that they can help other children who are disadvantaged in the community and also empowering themselves to have a better future. Your attendance is a very good blessing to me. For your time, ladies and gentlemen, I thank you. That's it.
The first award, Your Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, goes to the Ambassador of Malawi, His Excellency Mwaiwayo Polepole. Mm-hmm. Yes, let's have the music. Okay, so next in line, the second embassy to win an award in 2022 is the Embassy of Rwanda. Rwanda's ambassador to Zimbabwe, H.E. James Musoni. Let's clap hands for him as he comes, please, to receive his award. Yes, let's have the music. And the next embassy to win this year is the Palestine Embassy in Zimbabwe. H.E. Dr. Tama Almasri. Congratulations, Your Excellency. For outstanding contributions there. So next in line for an outstanding contribution to diplomacy, sustainable development and community building. Congratulations to H.E. Bronte Mulls, Ambassador of Australia. Thank you, Your Excellency. Moving on to the next award winner, again for outstanding contribution to diplomacy, sustainable development, and community building. Congratulations to the Japanese ambassador to Zimbabwe, H.E. Satoshi Tanaka. For outstanding contribution to diplomacy, sustainable development, and community building, the next award, ladies and gentlemen, goes to the Ambassador of Sweden to Zimbabwe, H.E. Asa Persson. I'd like to invite the founder of these awards, Mr. Reginald Chapunga, to join the guest of honor on stage and help us to present the next two awards. Let's clap hands for the man who came up with this vision, the visionary. Well done, sir. Now, for outstanding contribution to international cooperation, sustainable development and community building, ladies and gentlemen, the next award goes to the Ambassador of Sweden to Zimbabwe. Actually, goes to the Embassy of Sweden. So we are now recognizing organizations that have played a pivotal role in the upliftment of people's lives and livelihoods. So the next award being given for outstanding contribution in promoting AIDS-free health and empowered communities, the award goes to Mashambanzo Care Trust. Mashambanzo. There are round of applause for Mashambanzo Care Trust, working so hard to reduce or to make sure there is HIV-free prevalence in Zimbabwe. Wonderful, wonderful. Now, moving on. Being given an outstanding contribution to food security and climate action, ladies and gentlemen, the next award goes to H.E. Patrice Tala Tokakom, FAO Sub-Regional Coordinator for Southern Africa. Congratulations. Let's clap hands for him. Let's clap hands for him. Let's clap hands for him. Thank you so much. Moving on. And being awarded for outstanding contribution to community, youth, women movement, and private sector engagement participation in national development. The next award, ladies and gentlemen, goes to His Excellency Edward Cologne, the United Nations Resident Coordinator to Zimbabwe. Congratulations, sir. Wonderful. I'll allow the founder of these special awards, Reginald Chapunga, to take his seat and invite on stage Miss Anora Swanda to come through and help us to hand over the next group of awards. Anora is the co-founder of the, the Diplomat Business Club. Okay, so welcome, ma'am. Moving on to organizations, remember earlier on I said we are not just awarding embassies and ambassadors this time around, but there are organizations that have done a fantastic job in terms of activities, programs to do with poverty alleviation, youth empowerment, women empowerment, health issues, so many other things to do with the sustainable development goals. So those organizations, for the first time in the history of these awards, are also being recognized for outstanding performances. So the first award for outstanding contribution to peace and sustainable development goes to 4-H Zimbabwe Foundation. Moving on, this award is given in recognition of outstanding contribution to environment, climate action, and youth development. Congratulations to Zimbabwe Sunshine Group. Zimbabwe Sunshine Group. Okay. Anora will receive it on their behalf. Thank you. All right, so moving on, and this award is being given in recognition of outstanding contribution to HIV, sexual and reproductive health rights awareness and support programs. Congratulations to Population Solutions for Health. Population Solutions for Health. We continue. This award is being given in recognition of outstanding contribution to clean energy and rural communities empowerment. Congratulations to Mobility for Africa. All right, we have come to the end of the awards section. So let's give a round of applause to our guest of honor and to Miss Swanda as they take their seats.
What kind of man are you gonna be? A man who's lost his culture and his ways. A man who's given up all it was meant to be, just to make the world around him feel important. Simam kaka usarunga manaka chokira nzira ya wafamba uchakuona kachana. It's gonna be a long way, still you gotta make it someday. Talk about change, diwe, from nothing to something. I'm headed to the top. Kwatoyenda kure, kwatinova kure.
Thank you for joining us on today's episode of The Diplomat Couch. That's all we had for you, the awarding and honoring of embassies and organizations that are making a significant contribution to the citizens of Zimbabwe. And of particular note today is the young blessing, a 16-year-old rural girl from Guruwe who is making such an impact in her community. Blessing will be launching her foundation in the next coming months, and we hope the Diplomat Business Network Club and the community will come in their numbers to support this young lady's initiative. Thank you.